Hello friends, in today's class we are going to talk about the last phase of front-end that is called as intermediate code generation. Welcome again, and now the next topic is your intermediate code generation. Okay, so in intermediate code generation, we are going to talk about the first thing that we'll see that where it is required and why it is required. Okay, so a few points here that there is a parser that we have already seen, and then there is a static checker, and finally we are having an intermediate code generator. Now, this intermediate code is the final phase of compiler front end. Okay, front end of, and this should be within bracket. So it's the final phase of the front end of compiler. So up to here, everything is in front end, and this parser thing, the semantic analysis, the lexical part. So these all are lexical, then syntax, and then semantic. All are part of your, and then finally your IR is your front end, and then the back end start here, and then back end is consist of your code optimization. This is a part of back end, and finally code generation. Okay, so these two parts is your back end. So this is the final phase of front end. That after that, there's no front end. Goal is to translate the program in a format expected by the compiler backend. So whatever these two phases, optimization and code generation phase is seeking, we have to represent that IR in that way. Okay. In a typical compiler, followed by intermediate code is optimization and machine code generation. So that is usual thing, that after that IR we will get the code optimization and code generation. Technique for the intermediate code can be used for the final code generation. So the way you are representing your IR intermediate representation, that will finally help in case of generation of your code. So that will finally help you in case of code generation. Okay, so that is the entire idea, that to represent in a certain format. One thing I can say here, that to understand intermediate representation is something like this. Suppose this is an expression b plus c multiplied by d divided by 10 and minus suppose e. This is a long expression. Okay, this is very long expression, and if you say that you generate the target code for this expression, so generating target code for this particular expression will be a bit difficult one, because we don't have an instruction to translate this entire. Yes, we do have an instruction for, let's say, C multiplied by D. We do have an instruction for C multiplied by D, and then we do have an instruction that if you give me the result in T1, then I do have a result to result for C multiplied by D. Let's say T1 and divide by 10. So I have to break it down. I have to break it down so that it will help me in finally generation of our code. So there, this intermediate code comes into the picture, that it is represented in somewhat in that format, so that it can be directly translated. It can be directly translated. Translated to this code. Target code. Okay, so let me write it as code target, not code target, target code. Okay. So that is why this intermediate code generation is required. Okay, so that's all. Thank you.